nice taking, man. Wait, and revenge himself upon them. Therefore, thus saith the Most High, Wahamashiach Yahushua, I will also stretch out my hand upon Edom.
Now the Most High said, I saw that. I saw what you did to my people. I saw what Esau did to the nation of Israel. Right? In this case, the tribe of Gad, so-called Native American Indians, right? He saw all that, and they're not gonna get a pass. They're gonna pay. It's gonna be, James Brown talked about the big payback. That's this right here, right?
Read. And we'll cut off man and beast from it.
Right.
And I will make it desolate from Timon, and they of Dedan shall fall by the sword.
Right, read.
And I will lay my vengeance upon Edom.
The Most High said, I will lay my vengeance upon Edom, the so-called Caucasians.
Read. By the hand of my people, Israel.
By the hand of his people, Ishmael.
Israel.
Moab.
Israel.
The Japanese.
Israel.
The African.
Israel.
Israel, man. The holy nation of Israel. We're going to get revenge, and it's going to be when our leader comes back, man. Hamashiach Yahushua. That's when it's time to go. To go forth, man. We waiting on the Most High. And Hamashiach Yahushua to give the order, man. Because we ain't got no power. We can't do nothing. Without the Most High and the Mashiach Yahushua, we can't do nothing, man. We don't have no power here. Other than, you know, as far as gun, you know, trying to rebel against the government and all that nonsense, man, with guns. That failed. Marching. No justice, no peace. You ain't getting no justice, but we know we're not getting no justice, really. Excuse me. We're not gonna get no justice in this land, man. Go back to, matter of fact, go back to Habakkuk 2 and 12. It's a part, you know. I'm going in my segment on this, man. Because it makes me mad think about it. It really does. You know? Castrating us, cutting off how could you cut off another man's...
That's the beef.
For real. Right? That's right, man. Read that.
Habakkuk.
Oh, man.
But I ain't seen
that. Right? Yeah. Read that.
The book of Habakkuk, chapter 2, verse 12. Woe to him that buildeth a town with blood.
Right.
Established a city by iniquity.
Right.
Behold, is it not of the Most High of hosts that the people shall labor in the very...
That was the point I wanted on that. The woe to the people that buildeth the town by iniquity and by bloodshed, man. And that's America, man. The America in itself, what does that word mean? It means bitter, man. Everything about this place is bitter, even the origins of it. Understand? So I want to give all praise to the Most High, power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You know, giving thanks for all things, for the eyesight, for the ability to walk, everything, man. You can't take nothing for granted, man. Understand? So we give all praise to Yahweh by Shalom Mashiach Yahushua. Uh-oh. God. All praise and glory. Give me Colossians 3:17. We come forth and we bring in this truth to our people and knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of the Bible concerning who we are as the children of Israel. Let's read Colossians 3:17.
The book of Colossians, chapter 3, verse 17. And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all by Hashem HaMashiach Yahusha, giving thanks to the Most High and the Father by Hashem HaMashiach Yahusha.
Right, so everything that we do is going to be in the name of the Lord and Savior,
will give all praise and glory and thanks to the most high power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Jacob being the forefather of the 12 tribes of Israel. Look at Isaiah 58:3. There's a problem, like right now, y'all get ready to celebrate Thanksgiving. We say Thanksgiving, because wasn't that given to a so-called white man when he came into America. You understand? That's why we say thanks murdering. You know, thanks killing. Thanks destroying. And thanks stealing. Along with thanks taking. Ain't no giving nothing. Read this. The book of Isaiah chapter 58 verse 3. Wherefore have we fasted? Say they. Psalms 58:3. Psalms 58:3. See, we got to make sure that we understand what this is. Read. The book of Psalms chapter 58 verse 3. The wicked are estranged from the womb. Say the wicked are estranged from the womb. Who the wicked? Job 9:24. Hold that. Job 9:24. The wicked are estranged from the womb. That means as soon as they be born, they're estranged. Job 9:24. The book of Job. The book of Job, chapter 9, verse 24. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. The earth been given to the hand of the wicked. So I mean the wicked is ruling right now, read. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. So the wicked cover the faces of the judges thereof, read. If not, if he ain't the wicked, if the so-called white man ain't the wicked, read. Where? And who is he? Where? And who is the wicked? That's the question. Now we know this. Psalms 58:3 again. The book of Psalms, chapter 58, verse 3. The wicked are estranged from the womb. So the wicked, the so-called white men are estranged from the womb. Read. They go astray as soon as they be born. They go astray as soon as they be born. When they be born, what they be speaking? Speaking lies. Speaking what? Speaking lies. Now, surely they tell the truth. Speaking lies. Well, how you gonna believe in Thanksgiving when they doing what? Speaking lies. Oh, it's the time that the pilgrims came across the waters and they sat down with the Native Americans and they had a big feast, like y'all gonna feast on this day. Me, what they do? Speaking lies. Speaking lies, man. Proverbs 28:29-2. See, the problem with our people, we are subject to following the ways of the heathen, these other nations. It has always been our downfall in falling into the captive mind of the oppressor, the one that put you in slavery, the one that's not going to do a damn thing for you, but yet still you going to follow his holidays. What's wrong with y'all? Read the book of Proverbs, chapter 29, verse 2. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. You hear that? When the righteous are in authority, the people are happy. Are y'all happy now? Y'all say Obama gonna do everything. Were you happy during the 8 years that you just been in office? No. What you think gonna happen now? They say when the righteous are in authority, the people what? The people rejoice. The people rejoice. So why are they protesting since Trump got in office? Got elected or selected, not elected, but selected as the president of the United States. Why are people marching and crying the blues? Oh, we can't take it. Trump pinch. We can't take it. You know what I'm saying? Read. When the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. They say when the righteous are in authority, the people rejoice. Ain't nobody running around happy now.
Right.
Why not? Why y'all ain't screaming, oh, we love America. Bless America. Anybody crying that now?
Right.
Anybody crying about, oh, we love America. But listen. But when the wicked bears rule, the people mourn. That's why y'all running around like a chicken with his head cut off. What we gonna do? Trump's in office. Come on. I could have told you they're gonna put him in office. Come on. You should be prepared for either evil. Either one you should be prepared for. It didn't matter who was elected. Choose one of your evils. Speaking poison, right? Come on. Give me Isaiah 24:5. See, our problem is, as a people, we just go with the flow. Whatever the flow is, we flow right with it. Instead of looking at, wait a minute now, we've been flowing this way and all we've been doing is floating. We ain't going nowhere. We're just floating. We're just floating all around this way, that way, everywhere. You know why? Read the book of Isaiah chapter 24 verse 5. The earth also is defiled under the inhabitants thereof.
Yeah, the earth, the whole earth is what?
Defiled under the inhabitants thereof.
This earth is defiled under the inhabitants thereof.
Really? Because they have transgressed the laws.
Because they have transgressed the laws of the Most High. All of this earth gonna be in shape in the spirit of righteousness again is when Hamashiach Gabashiach come back and put all the armies, the navies, the marines, and the air force down.
That's right.
Where it'll be nothing but dust and smell of smoke.
Right.
He's gonna eradicate all military of all nations. And then righteousness is gonna be set on this earth. And what y'all gonna be doing then? Gonna be cleaving to Israel. Oh, you're gonna wanna know then. Y'all think we some fools right now, but we're gonna find out who's gonna laugh last.
Right.
You know? Laugh now, cry later. Yeah, laugh now and cry later. Because you think this is a joke. A lot of y'all going around, y'all just follow whatever it is that you need to follow of the world. Give me Jeremiah 10 and 2. Getting on. Some of you might commit suicide because you ain't got enough money to buy food for Thanksgiving. Our people is dumb, man. They just finished.
Right.
You finished, man. Come on. Like to say it because ignorant means not knowing. And you're ignorant if you're going to sit down and celebrate a day when they had us doing all you can think of and can't think of. That's wicked as ever. Come on now. Y'all done seen Roots. They gave you a little bit of it. But that's nothing compared to what they did to us, y'all. You wouldn't be walking around the street right now, man, if it was 1700. Your butt be in some chains and shackles. And they be getting ready to take you to have whoever they want to have with you. But now y'all got a little time to run around the plantation like you free. You ain't free. You gonna find out who's free. I bet that Walmart over there ain't gonna be opening up soon, is it? They shutting them down, ready for concentration camps. You better believe it. And every last one of them is railroad tracks is leading right to the Walmarts. Ain't they putting a railroad track that's gonna come up out of the ground? Where? Look at it, right? Right there, right? You see it across the street right there? Gonna come up out of the ground right there and make sure they can drop them off.
Right.
Walmart. Look at Walmart. W-A-L-M-A-R-T. Go backwards, because they put it in your face and they laugh at you. It's martial law. It's coming. That's why no sooner election come happened what they do. They out there on the street protesting. Over and over again. When martial law is called, you're going to find out what's going to happen then. All y'all walk around here holding hands and enjoying yourself. You better get ready for what's going to go down. Because it's going to go down. Read the book of Jeremiah, chapter 10, verse 2. Thus says the Most High. Well, this is what the Most High and Hamashiach Gabashiach want you to hear. Read. Learn not the way of the heathen.
No, learn to celebrate all the hella days that they set up. And they don't know nothing about the Most High's holy days.
Right.
He said, what?
Learn not the way of the heathen.
Then learn not the way of the heathen. These other nations. Read.
And be not dismayed at the signs of heaven.
Yeah, everybody dismayed at the signs of heaven. Look up in the sky. Oh, look at that. 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 They amazed. They amazed at it. Read.
For the heathen are dismayed at them.
See, the heathen, all these other nations outside of the 12 tribes of Israel, they amazed at these things. Why? Psalms 96 and 5. You are Hebrew Israelite. That's your nationality. I got what, 58 different identities of who we are now? 68, Slovakia. 68. Dang, that's lost, man. Read.
The book of Psalms, chapter 96, verse 5.
For all the idols of the nation, all the gods of the nations are idols.
All the gods of the nations are idols. That's why I said, learn not to wear the heathen. Psalms 106 and 35. That's why you're getting ready for Thanksgiving. Thanks murdering. Thanks killing. Thanks destroying. Thanks wickedness. Because that's all it is, man. That's all you can say it is, but you can't say that's anything else besides that when you understand the origin of Thanksgiving. Matter of fact, when they had the first one, they had 2 days that they celebrated it. Not just one day, 2 days. Murdering and killing us. Read.
The book of Psalms, chapter 106, verse 35. But we're mingled among the heathen.
Here we are mingled among the heathen, all over America. But that's where I'm dealing with. I'm here, so I'm dealing with America right now. Read.
And learn their works.
And learn their works. Thanksgiving, Christmas, Halloween. Y'all probably celebrating Halloween. Wickedness, because you're a bunch of wicked people. You see? That's why we live for the one-third of the 12 tribes of Israel that will come out of this wickedness and follow what the Most High say and get ready for the kingdom that's going to last forever and ever and ever. Let's read.
And they served their idols.
See, they served their idols. Read.
Which were a snare unto them.
Look, all the gods of the nations are idols. So everything they're dealing with is idolatry. They ain't dealing with the Most High power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We done read it to you in Wisdom of Solomon 5 and 7. As for the way of the Most High, as for the way of Mashiach Yahushai, the nation gonna say, these heathen gonna say, we have not known it. You understand? Hear the word of the Most High, because it's going to be a time when you ain't going to be able to hear this. We ain't going to be on the streets. He's going to shut it down. It's going to be a time when you're going to hear this truth. And all you that hear, he goes, where the brothers at? Where them Hebrew Israelites at? Oh, they ain't going to be around no more. Because we're going to be in our sanctuary of pleasing the Most High, and he's going to have us safe. Somewhere outside from wherever you're going to be at. Where you going to be? Well, all you know is to be in the world. That's all you know. You ain't going to know what to do, because the Most High ain't going to deal with you, because you have not called upon him. You ain't called upon him. You don't know him. He's calling out to you, but you refuse to hear him. And then he's calling out to you through the men that he have called on his last days to bring forth this truth. Read it again.
The book of Psalms, 106, chapter 106, verse 35. But were mingled among the heathen, and learned their works, and they served their idols, which were a snare unto them.
Damn, this a trap. It's a trap. Can you imagine the elite, how they laughing at our people? Not only that, all these holidays are humanized sacrifices. They sacrificing people. Why do you think all these bodies, all these people that's missing in, on the Walmart walls all the time, where do you think they're at? What, they never find them. You ever thought about it? I ask people all across the country, look in the Walmart, and what do you see? You see, have you seen me? They used to put them on the milk cartons. They used to have little fires that came out with two of them on there all the time. They never find them people. Because they're being sacrificed. And here you are following the way of the heathen. You might end up being a sacrifice. Before it's over, they got concentration camps ready for you. What you gonna do when they come for you? I know what you're gonna do. You're gonna call on the Lord. Remember y'all said, all you gotta do is call on the name of the Lord and you're gonna be saved. So you call on the name of the Lord when they come after you and see if you're gonna be saved. Because they're coming. Because it's written. And they already put all these different projects in motion. These agendas that they already signed to take you down. They tired. They said Planned Parenthood ain't working. So we got something else for you. We're going to kill them in the food. We're going to kill them with the medicine. And we, and that don't do it, we're going to pick them up and put them in concentration camps and burn them up. Y'all look at them caskets that they have. Thousands and thousands of big, these big caskets, they say, oh, I can hold so many bodies. You better, them FEMA coffins, right? You better understand this. Those coffins can hold a lot of people when they burn your butt up. But
put them ashes in there. You know what I mean? Get rid of them. Put them in there. Dump them in the ground. Put a hole. Dump them in the ground. How many can you put in the ground when you burn somebody up? They got the ovens already. Guillotines, cut, chop off their head. They already voting the fact that some states, they want to say, hey, let us do use the guillotine as a means of killing us. Who the man wants that big kill? It's us. Read. Verse 37. Yeah, they sacrifice their sons and their daughters unto devils. That sacrifice the sons and daughters unto devils, man. Because y'all following the way of devils. Oh, y'all, they ain't gonna talk about the white man. Oh, they ain't gonna talk about devils. But we talking about what's real from the Bible. Revelation 2 and 10. Revelation 2 and 10. Read. The book of Revelation, chapter 2, verse 10. Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison. Ain't that where we at? Ain't that where we end up at? On a large scale. So we sacrifice our children to devils. Not only that, you call yourself Gentiles. Get on 1 Corinthians 10 and 20. See, it's sad because we as a people, we should know better. All the things we've been through, look down, look there. Look at all we've been through. We're talking about we the children of Israel, read. The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 10, verse 20. But I say that the things which the Gentiles sacrifice, the things that the Gentiles sacrifice or worship, read, they sacrifice to devils. Sacrifice to what? To devils. And see, this is a problem. We gave our children to who? To devils. Devils. Read. And not to the Most High. And not to the Most High. Not to the Most High. Yep. Read. And I would not that ye should have fellowship with devils. You don't want us to have fellowship with devils. Read. Ye cannot drink the cup of the Most High and the cup of devils. Ye cannot be partakers of the Most High's table and of the table of devils. We can't drink of the Most High's table. Or Mashiach Gavashai table. Can't sit down with him. And you drinking the cup of devils? He said, learn not to wear the heathen. But you're still, this is who you are. Stand before him and say, I followed everything that the heathen said. I followed everything that the devil told me. I was a good nigga. Mashiach Gavashai. I was good. He said it's okay for man to man to lie down. I say it's okay. Because they said we got to follow the law of the land. Right? That's why I say learn not to wear the heathen. You got to do the things that's right according to the scriptures. The Most High's holy word. You don't have to accept the wickedness and abomination that's being done. We as a Hebrew Israelite stand against that. That's why they're devils. Deceitful and evil people. Ain't nothing righteous about them. Because you can't name nothing righteous since, according to this Bible, since they've been on the earth. And all of you that follow them, two-thirds of our people, you ain't no better either. You're a bunch of rebellious people. And the Most High gonna deal with you because you don't want to come back to him. You got a chance to repent and ask for forgiveness and come back to the Most High, who is our power, and he only know us. You can't show me why he know anybody else but Israel. He's the God of Israel. He's the power of Israel. He ain't the power of nobody else. But y'all so meek, and you're ready to look at a brother or downplay your brother, but you won't look at your enemy in his eye and tell him nothing. Y'all better get ready, because they getting ready for you. They been ready for you. But one thing they can't fight, and that's this. Get up, Ecclesiasticus 39 and 28. They can't fight this. Get your stealth bombers and your flying saucers and your your AK-47s, your 50 millimeters, whatever you got to fight with. Fight against this. Read out of the Apocrypha. The book of Ecclesiasticus, chapter 39, verse 27. Okay. 28, Salakia. There be spirits that are created for vengeance.
Yeah, there be spirits that are created for vengeance. What are these spirits also? Give me Psalms. Hold that. Get Psalms 104 and 4. So there be spirits. These spirits are created for vengeance. What are these spirits?
The book of Psalms, chapter 104, verse 4. Who maketh his angels spirits?
He maketh his angels spirits. So what, angels are spirits. Spirits are angels. You see? Spirits are angels. Angels are spirits. You either can say spirit or can say angel. Either or. Read.
His minister is a flaming fire.
His minister is a flaming fire. What do they do? What do his ministers do at this flaming fire? Jeremiah 23, 29. So these angels are under commandment of the Most High. That's why you're looking at all this carnal, all this fleshly things that they're preparing for. Prepare for this. Read.
The book of Jeremiah, chapter 23, verse 29. Is not my word like as a fire?
Oh, these angels are bringing the word of the Most High, a flaming fire. So it's not my word like what?
Like as a fire, saith the Most High, well, how much y'all can have a shot? And like a hammer that breaketh the rock in pieces.
They're like a hammer that breaketh the rock in pieces. That hammer is powerful. I don't care how strong the rock is. Or the word of the Most High, it's going to break it into pieces. So let's look at this hammer that the Most High is talking about. Y'all talking about a hammer? Let's see what that hammer is. Most High, put that, bring that hammer down. Go back to Ezekiel. Ecclesiastes 39 to 28.
Right.
The Most High. Let him bring that hammer down with these angels. Read.
The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 39, verse 28. There be spirits that are created for vengeance.
And these spirits, these angels, are created for vengeance. Read.
Which in their fury lay on some strokes, on sword strokes. In the time of destruction, they pour out their force.
So the time of destruction, these angels, these spirits, gonna pour out their force. Read.
And appease the wrath of him that made them.
And they're gonna appease the wrath for the Most High. Power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And Jacob being the forefather of the 12 tribes of Israel. They will appease the Most High who made them. Read.
Fire.
Fire. Let's see you fight.
Fire.
Let's see you fight.
Fire.
Next. Let's see you fight.
And hail.
Let's see you fight. Hail coming out of the sky.
And famine.
Let's see you fight food shortages. Read. Right.
And death.
Let me see you fight death. When the Most High said, I kill.
Right.
And I make alive. Read.
All these were created for vengeance.
All these were created for what?
For vengeance.
For vengeance. Come on.
Teeth the wild beast.
Teeth the wild beast, man.
Right.
Yeah. This one's gonna be eating you up. You don't know where they're gonna come from. Teeth the wild beast. Read.
And scorpions.
Scorpions gonna be tearing your butt up. Read.
Serpents.
Serpents. Poisonous snakes gonna be tearing your butt up. Read.
And the sword.
And the sword. What's the matter with that sword? All type of weaponry, ordinances, guns. Read.
Punishing the wicked to destruction.
Punishing who?
The wicked to destruction.
Punishing the wicked to destruction. This is the good news. Believe this. They can't run from this. They can't hide from this.
They shall rejoice in his commandment.
They're going to rejoice in his commandment. To the angels. Gonna rejoice in the commandment of the Most High. The spirits gonna rejoice in the commandment of the Most High when they bring this destruction upon the wicked, as it is written, right?
And they shall be ready upon earth.
Where they gonna be at?
Ready upon earth.
Where these angels at?
Ready upon earth.
Where they at?
Ready upon earth.
Are they in commandment of the Most High?
Ready upon earth when need is.
When there's a need. It is a Jacob's trouble. And there is a need. And they coming. They gonna do some damage. Straight up. Read.
And when their time is come.
And when their time has come, it's right here. We need them. Read.
They shall not transgress his word.
They ain't gonna transgress the Most High's word. They gonna bring the destruction upon our enemies.
and all the people that hate us, man. Because we're going to be saved, but we don't know what saved means.
Coming soon.
All right, that's right. You can see it.
Coming soon.
You can feel it, right? You got it, man. That's right. Give me Ezekiel 35 and 5. See, there's a reason why destruction going to come, man. And why these angels going to be dealing with them. Because a certain... Right. Right. You're right. Read. The book of Ezekiel, chapter 35, verse 5. Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and has shed the blood of the children of Israel. So when they kill us, when the cops kill us, what's the verdict? What the verdict been? For all of us. Not guilty. Not guilty. Listen, read it. And when they, before that, when they came over here in 1492, man, come on. They came over here in 1492, man, they took us off our land. They raped our women. They raped the men. They raped the children. They raped the cats, the dogs, the chickens. Say what?
They're trying to act innocent now.
Right, innocent now.
They're righteous now.
No.
Like in the Bible, the Bible said that the devil is the accuser.
The accuser.
So who does he accuse? He accuses our people.
Yeah, that's right.
You're a criminal.
That's right. Read. And shed the blood of the children of Israel.
I agree with y'all.
Verse 5. Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and has shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword. By the force of the sword, man. The matter of the sword is the gun, right? What's Zechariah 11 and 5? Yeah.
I agree with y'all, but me, personally, I'm not worthy.
Why?
I'm drinking the beer.
We drink.
Cigarette.
I will smoke a cigarette. You got to stop smoking cigarettes.
I'm not worthy.
Well, that's good. That's humble. That's humility, brother. But you have an opportunity to repent and get yourself together, man, and come on and stand with us, man.
But I agree with what you say,
but it ain't an individual thing, though, right? It's not an individual thing, though. You got to come and be with us, man. Come and be with us, man. You can stand. You already got the mindset. Nobody guaranteed to make it. Nobody was strong before they start learning the word of the Most High in truth. You understand? None of us. So what you saying, I'll tell you my story. What you saying now ain't nothing to me. You understand what I'm saying? I understand what you saying, but that's humility that you're saying, but a lot of us, man, we come out of a hell of a life, man.
You're strong.
Or the world.
You're strong. You guys are all strong. I'm not strong. I'm weak. I can't get over alcohol. I can't get over cigarettes.
Yes, because you're saying that you can't. But when you say you can,
I tried to.
Yeah, but you can. You just need help.
You're gonna make it. I'm not gonna make it. But I believe in what you're saying, though. I fight for it.
Yeah, but just because you drink and smoke, you saying that's the reason why you're not gonna make it? Only.
Yeah, because like that's not gonna enter the kingdom of heaven.
Look, we drank. The first miracle of Mashiach was that devil was he turned water into wine. Get Matthew 11 and 19.
See, I respect all you guys.
Well, I'm saying, but you gotta understand, you gotta hear the truth, really, because you have an opportunity, man. You can say two things, man, that you're doing. Only one thing that you said you're doing that's wrong is smoking, man. That's it.
Smoking and drinking, right?
You an alcoholic? You an alcoholic? You an alcoholic? Are you an alcoholic?
Yes.
Oh, read this. The book of St. Matthew, chapter 11, verse 19. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, behold, a man gluttonous. And a wine bibber. Somebody say I got outside, man. So it's just a matter of you coming to get help, brother. You gotta get help. My number's on there, man. What's your name?
My name is Justin.
Justin?
It's the government white name.
You sure?
Justin, yeah. Time,
that's okay though, man. You just in time, right? You better say you just in time. Get his number, man. So I communicate with him. We can communicate, man. We can help you come out of that situation, man. That's what we're here for, man, to help our people. We're here. That's our purpose, man, to wake you up, man. All right, brothers. Shalom. You know, to wake our people up because we out here because we love you, man. And that's what it's about. What is it if we out here teaching and we can't show help to our brothers and sisters that need help? No. You just got to learn, man. You just got to learn.
Because you really don't know enough to be able to call yourself a hypocrite in what you're doing as far as what you're saying to yourself as a smoker. So, go back to where you was at. How you doing? You was at Zechariah 11 and 5. Yeah. No, he said he's a hypocrite because he can't stand with us because he, said what? King James 16:11 Bible. Nah, you can't prove it. Huh? Yeah, but that's, he got horns in his head. That ain't the real deal. Read this. The book of Zechariah, chapter 11, verse 5. Whose possessors slay them, whose possessors slay us, read, and hold themselves not guilty.
Yeah.
They hold themselves not guilty. That's why when we get shot down, the verdict is not guilty. Not guilty. Not guilty. Well, one thing for sure, we know that our people are deceived by their own vain opinion. We know that. And an evil suspicion overthrown their judgment. We understand that. Ecclesiastes 3:24. So I mean, it's like either he had to be some way. He didn't come in here. He had appearance. Read
the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, verse 24. For many are deceived by their own vain opinion, and an evil suspicion has overthrown their judgment.
That's right. And the main evil suspicion that is overthrown the judgment is because our people are following the way of the wicked. They learn the ways of the wicked. Therefore, they come up against what it is that's real, the truth. They're looking for another way. Go back to Ezekiel 35 and 5. See, I pray that our people can come out of this madness, you know. That's why they put the drugs on the earth. Right in our hood. You see what I'm saying? All kind of drugs that we undertaking. And think we righteous. Think we deep, right? Smoke your blood, you get deep. You can break down everything. You more deeper than anybody that don't smoke. Smoke them weed, that weed, you be in some kind of some kind of state of magical state. I mean, you, wow, you, oh yeah, I'm deep, man. Come on now. Now they're right. Read
the book of Ezekiel, chapter 35, verse 5. Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and hast shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword in the time of their calamity.
See, that's what y'all gotta look at. And say they shed our blood in the time of our calamity. See, they shed our blood in the time of our calamity. Ready?
In the time that their iniquity had an end.
In the time that our iniquity had an end. What do you think that is, y'all? Get out Revelations 12 and 12. In the time that our iniquity, our wickedness had an end. When our iniquity have an end, we get ready to take over. And they know it. That's why listen, me.
The book of Revelation, chapter 12, verse 12. Therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea. For the devil is come down unto you, having great wrath.
Hear that? The devil has come down upon us, we the children of Israel, having great wrath. Because that's who the Bible's talking to, us, the children of Israel. So the devil that came down having much wrath, really,
because he knoweth that he has but a short time.
Because he, the devil, knoweth that he has but a what?
A short time.
A short time. Verse 17.
Verse 17. And the dragon was wroth with the woman.
So the devil, who is Satan, who is the serpent, who is the dragon, who is Esau, who are the Edomites, was wroth with the woman, who represents us, the children of Israel. So they're going to be wroth with us, as we just said. Read.
And went to make war with the remnant of her seed.
Went to make war with the remnant of her seed. The remnant. Because 2/3 of y'all go, they gonna do you in. I'm telling you, 2/3 of our people, they gonna wipe you out. In a real way. Read.
which keep the commandments of the Most High and have the testimony of Hamashiach Yahweh Shai.
That's the Hebrew Israelites. One third is a remnant of the 12 tribes of Israel that they're coming after. But oh, y'all, remember we talk about them angels that's on this earth waiting for the commandment of the Most High to do His will? Psalms 34 and 7. Understand this. And understand this point. Psalms 34 and 7. See those spirits, them angels, they right here on the commandment, right here on the earth, waiting for the commandment of the Most High. Read.
The book of Psalms, chapter 34, verse 7. The angel of the Most High encampeth round about them that fear Him.
The angel of the Most High encampeth around them that fear Him. Read.
And delivereth them. Oh, taste and see that the Most High is good.
See? Delivereth us. That's how we're going to be delivered. Y'all think it's something that's far-fetched, but get Revelation 19:11.
Right.
Y'all think it's something far-fetched, but it's going to go down. But it's going to go down, and when it go down, you better be ready. You better have a relationship with the Most High, power of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, before it's too late. Call on Him. Read. Learn of Him. Read.
The book of Revelation, chapter 19, verse 11. And I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse. And he that sat upon him was called Faithful and True.
This is a Mashiach Yahweh Shai, the anointed Savior, the only begotten Son of the Most High, coming back to judge and make war. Listen.
And in righteousness he doth judge and make war.
So he's coming back with a righteous judgment. A righteous judgment and making war. Read.
His eyes were as a flame of fire.
Was he going to be mad as ever? Read.
And on his head were many crowns. And he had a name written that no man knew but he himself.
That's right. Powers and authority has been given to him. Most High has given him power to judge, to make the judgment. According to the power of the Most High. Read.
And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood.
So he's going to be clothed with his garment going to be dipped in blood. So that means somebody's blood going to be on his garment. Read.
And his name is called the Word of the Most High.
And his name is called the Word of the Most High. He's bringing the Word of the Most High. Read.
And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses.
The armies which are in heaven, the angels, that are hosts, that are armies of the Most High, armies of Hamashiach Yahweh Shai, gonna follow him in righteousness. Read.
Clothed in fine linen, white and clean, and out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword.
So the angels, how many angels? Revelation 9:16. The angels following him in righteousness, as he's coming in righteousness to do what? To judge and make war and set righteousness on this earth forever and ever and ever. Read.
The book of Revelation, chapter 9, verse 16. And the number of the army of the horsemen were 200,000,000.
So the number of the army of the horsemen were 200,000,000. That's 200 million angels that's coming to judge and make war with Hamashiach Yahweh Shai. Remember, it said the angel of the Most High encampeth around those that fear him. You see? That's an angel. Two angels. It only took two angels
right
to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah. Two angels destroy five big cities. You understand? 200 million angels are coming back with the Mashiach Yahweh Shai to judge and make war. Read.
And out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that wicked he should smite the nation.
I mean, it can't get no clearer than that.
Everybody thinks, everybody's
online. Say, out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that wicked he should smite the nations. That means kill the nations. This is who you call Jesus Christ, but you don't know him like this. You don't know nothing about him like this. He said, a sharp sword will come out of his mouth that he's going to kill the nations. Read. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron. That rod of iron that he's going to rule them with is what we're telling you got to come back to. The law of the Most High. Period. Now, so that's deal. So they've been stealing all this time. What they going to do now? Going to be put to death because you can't stop. Thou shalt not kill or murder. You're murderers. You ain't got no chance. That's why you ain't got no mercy from the Most High. Only Esau. The only people that have no mercy from the Most High. And the Zondervan Van Compact Bible Dictionary tells you, Edom figures primarily in the prophetic scriptures as the scene of great future judgments. She is the only neighbor of the Israelites who is not promised any mercy from the Most High. The Most High said you're going to have mercy on Jacob and yet choose Israel and set us in our own land. You see? But see, we're looking at Most High love everybody. He don't love everybody. He don't even know everybody. He only know us. But y'all so meek. Y'all want to be so meek and think, oh, you don't even think about themselves. You don't even think about yourself. You always think about somebody else. I bet you. You stand before me, next thing you do, you're talking about somebody else, not even yourself. At least the brother was honest about himself. He wouldn't need to go into nobody else, you know what I mean? Saying he got to get himself together. We all got to get ourselves together and stay together. That's the main thing. When you get yourself together, you got to stay together. Don't go astray. Don't backslide. Don't go back out into the world. What'd she say?
Do you stay over here?
Huh?
You stay over here?
Right over there. That's where I come from.
Do you stay in the jail?
I used to, yeah.
You used to or you do now?
I don't know. What
does it matter?
Does it matter? Why does it matter?
Because if you did, you'll know what's going on around everything from the jungle to the Murray Park.
I know right now. This is what's going on with you. Most things is, it's the word. The word of the Most High. Ain't no more important than that.
I love Donald Trump.
Huh?
What's going on?
This was going on. Hosea 4 and 6.
Not that scripted bullshit. That's been going on for weeks. If you want to speak what's happening now, and you don't stay over here, well, you take that back where you came from. Because right now, from the jungle, you're going to be shutting down.
It's shutting down? Read. Yep. Yeah. The book of Hosea, chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee. We got to get the Most High to come back to you. To show you what time it is. Because all the things that you looking at, get up Jeremiah 17:9. Jeremiah 17:9. Get read verse 5 first. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 17, verse 5. Thus saith the Most High, cursed be the man that trusteth in man. Yeah, cursed be the man that trusteth in man. Read. And make a flesh his arm. Yeah, making some man like he got some kind of ability to stop what the Most High already ordaining that's happening in this earth. With the wicked. I mean, all you gotta do is say right now, shut it all down. No matter where you at, where you come from, it don't matter. We still the same people that's in the same condition, wherever we are, right? And whose heart departeth from the Most High, right? Whose mind departeth from the Most High. You ain't got nothing coming. Verse 9. The heart is deceitful above all things. And desperately wicked.
That's the way you think.
Wicked, not be.
He said your mind is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Read. Who can know it? Who can know it? And you only know it if you express your mind. That's why the Most High said, get Proverbs 1:22. The book of Proverbs, chapter 1, verse 22. How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity? And the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge. Turn you at my reproof.
the people that work for that freaking shop, some property taxes, they can get rent. The rent, the no rent control. The escrow. And the fact that men and women is raped. Take. What don't belong to them, and then they want to sell out, and then, you know, go along because, you know, money is a program.
You just need another battery.
No, none of my fucking community with all that illustration.
Read, where you at? The Book of Proverbs, chapter 1, verse 22.
And abuse of the mental health, and the children.
Read that. How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity? How long, ye simple ones, will you love simplicity? Read. And the scorners delight in their scorning. Against the word, read. And fools hate knowledge. That's why we destroy for a lack of knowledge. You see? Verse 7. The fear of the Most High is the beginning of knowledge. The fear of the Most High is the beginning of knowledge. Read. But fools despise wisdom and instruction. You see, get a hold of, get Hebrews 4 and 12. See, it's very important that we understand that we've been sent out here to wake you up from the darkness, from ignorance, not knowing the power that you have. We are chosen people that the Most High chose above all nations of the earth. This ain't something that you look down upon yourself and thinking of yourself. But most of you can't think of yourself because you got to think about somebody else. Read. The book of Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12. For the word of the Most High is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit, and of the joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. That's right, man. That's the word of the Most High. Go back to Proverbs 1 and 7. The word of the Most High is quick, powerful, and sharper than any two-edged sword. Mashiach Yahushua coming back.